our fifth grade promotion ceremony. Our boys and girls have worked so hard this year, and we are so excited to help them celebrate this great memory.
Under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed as the twilight was gleaming, whose broad stripes
Fernandez.
graduates, parents, and guests. My name is Abby Hernandez. I would like to take a few minutes to reflect on all of the good memories we have made here while at West Rockford, like our field trips to our nation's capital and the North Carolina campus. Also, let us not forget all of the fun we have had with field days and PBIS celebrations. As we go into middle school next year, let us remember all of the friendships we have made. Let us be careful with the choices we make so we aren't making the same mistakes over and over, not only in school, but also in life. We can't leave here tonight without giving credit where it is due. If it weren't for our wonderful teachers here at West Rockford and our parents, we wouldn't be the people we are today. So we say thank you to them. I'm going to leave you off with two quotes tonight. The first one is by J.K. Rowling. We do not need magic to transform our world. We carry all the power we need inside ourselves already. We have the power to imagine better. Second quote is by Eleanor Roosevelt. Learn from the mistakes of others. You can't live long enough to make all of them yourself. Thank you for giving me this opportunity to speak tonight, and good luck to all my fellow friends.
Today is a celebration, a time for looking back at lessons you learned at West Rockford, adventures shared, and bright moments filled with special meaning. Everybody here is looking forward to sixth grade, and because most of us will be going to sixth grade, I wanted to say that we're entering a new stage in life, and that every new thing that you will see in the following years, it could also bring a new start to the new school, filled with a new kid, but most importantly, a new you. Some people say that middle school could be the hardest time of your life mentally and physically because of the changes you're going through. But the only hard part that it will bring for us is the time to say goodbye to West Rockford. A time to say goodbye to good times, you know. A time to say goodbye, but say hello to sixth grade. But those kids that tried hard and worked harder will be going to college one day, and they'll be the ones walking across the stage later. I want to thank my family and the ones who helped me through pre-K all the way up to fifth grade and sixth grade for next year. My family is the one who helped me study and be the person I am today. And I also want to thank my friends who always supported me and the teachers in fifth grade, Ms. Andrews, Mr. Hunt, and Ms. Wells, for helping me learn new things every day. It will be a new start for everybody to set new goals, dream new dreams, and challenge your classmates to see who will make a bigger difference in tomorrow's new future.
My name is Omar Mendiola, and I'll be reading my speech in English and Spanish. Dear graduating fifth graders, I first want to congratulate everyone in the fifth grade class at West Rockford Elementary. All of us have worked hard at school, all of us have had fun, and now all of us are getting ready to move up to middle school. It's a little scary, right? After all, we're about to move to different schools and meet different people. We'll face pressure and stress like we never have yet before. To do our best in middle school and beyond takes leadership. We all need to be leaders. What are the qualities of being a leader? To me, a good leader has to have clear goals, strong communication skills, and a positive attitude. Primero, quiero felicitar a todos. Todos nosotros hemos trabajado duro en la escuela, todos nos hemos divertido en la escuela, y ahora todos nosotros nos estamos preparando para pasar a la escuela intermedia. Es un poco de miedo, ¿verdad? Después de todo, estamos a punto de mudarnos a diferentes escuelas y conocer a diferentes personas. Todos necesitamos ser líderes. ¿Qué son las cualidades de ser un líder? Para mí, un buen líder debe tener motivos claros, una comunicación sólida, habilidades y una actitud positiva. One thing that stands out in my life through the years is how all my teachers helped me grow academically, learning English in pre-K with Ms. Harbour, to Ms. Harris and Ms. Gaston helping me be a more fluent reader. I want to thank my parents, teachers, and Ms. Hunt who are helping me reach my goal of one day going to college. I'm going to leave you with a quote from Ben Carson. Through hard work, perseverance, and a faith in God, you can live your dreams. Una cosa que se destaca en mi mente a través de los años es como todos mis maestros me ayudaron a crecer académicamente, aprendiendo inglés en Trique con la señora Harbaugh, a la señora Harris y a la señora Jackson, ayudándome a ser un lector más fluido. Quiero agradecer a mis padres y maestros que me están ayudando a alcanzar mi meta de algún día ir a la universidad. Te voy a dejar una cita de Ben Carson. A través del trabajo duro, la perseverancia y la fe en Dios, puedes vivir tus sueños. Thank you so much for your time. Again, my name is Omar Mendiola. Boys, can you please come up? Miss Ferguson. Ferguson, we love you.
Who will be taking a new journey in her life as she's getting ready to go on her retirement. So we thank you for all of her service and everything she has done for these students at West Austin.
Good afternoon, I want to thank you all for coming to our different completion ceremony. My name is Cesar Castillo Soto, and I'm here today to share some of my talents right here at West Austin. When I was in kindergarten, I could not understand English, and I would get into a lot of trouble for that very reason. I had difficulty understanding what was expected of me. However, I quickly started to learn, and I made a lot of friends. Over the next few years, my English, and as well as my behavior, improved with the help of Ms. Harris and Ms. Taylor. In third grade, Ms. Abadi assigned an amazing 3D landscape project using clay, paint, and booking a board. By the time I reached fourth grade, things got a little more challenging, and I knew from then on that things were not going to be that easy. And of course, fifth grade came along and taught me that things can be tough and how they look like. I thank my family for supporting me along my journey through elementary school. I thank my mom in particular for helping me with my speech and taking care of me. I also want to thank my classmates and my teachers for helping me with my English over the years. And I also want to thank Ms. Torgerson for helping me in kindergarten and understanding English especially. In closing, I want to leave you with these words, my classmates. Never give up on your dreams and always believe in yourself. When you enter middle school, don't forget to make new goals and your dreams. Once again, I would like to thank everybody for coming this afternoon to help us celebrate. I will see you in the future as we make our transition to middle school. Fifth graders, we did it!
Back to Hamilton. Luke and Arthur. Manaya Bowman. Malcolm Boyd. Jamie Brandon. Aaron Brooks. Abby Hernandez, Raymond Jones, Anthony Lassiter, Danica McIntosh, Michaela Moore.
Someone has been a fabulous leader these past years, and we are going to miss her terribly. I told her that she's probably my most favorite principal that I've worked under. She's kind, and she's patient, and very supportive. We're really going to miss you, Ms. Hunter.